know, sometimes people ask me whether this idea of considering voltages as electric heights is not equivalent to thinking of voltages as electric pressures. Not quite. Both are powerful tools of visualization of what voltages do in an electric circuit. But let me go back a little, right, now that we have the time. In a hydraulic circuit, we have pipes instead of electric wires. And inside those pipes, we have water instead of electric charges, instead of electricity. And when we have that water moving, we measure the flow of water in those pipes in liters per second. While in an electric circuit wire, we measure the motion of electricity in coulombs per second. That is the electric current. So we have flow of water in one case, and we have electric current in the other. Of course, coulombs per second is a unit. We gave it a name. We call that the ampere, the amp. But that is already a given. Now let's move on. What does get the water to move in a hydraulic circuit? Those are the pumps, or rather the pressure that pumps apply to the water inside the pipes. And in an electric circuit, well, batteries. That's why we think of batteries sometimes as sort of electric pumps. And that is a beautiful metaphor. I love it. I have used it. I have taught it myself. Think of voltage as an electric pressure. Think of batteries as electric pumps that get electricity in the wires in the circuit to move, to create an electric current in your circuit. That is fine. But that is a metaphor. Thinking of voltages as an electric height is not a metaphor. That is the reality. Let me tell you why. Heights. Let's revisit the concept of height. What is height? Height is a perception of a human brain of the difference in gravitational potential between two points. And you're thinking, so what's that? Yeah, of course, we don't even think about heights anymore. It's ingrained in our brains, right? But that's what it is. Between two points inside a gravitational field like this one, and this one of them is higher than the other. The reality is that this one has more gravitational potential than this one. A kilogram here has more joules of potential energy than the same kilogram down here. That our brain translates into, oh, this point is higher than this one. The reality is that what we're perceiving is the difference in joules per kilogram between those two points. And because we've been doing that instinctively since we were born, we don't think about that. We just say this point is higher than this one. Oh, more joules per kilogram of difference. Oh, well, bigger the difference in height. Well, that's interesting. When we have an altimeter inside an airplane, what that altimeter is measuring actually is the difference of gravitational potential energy between the airplane level and the chosen level of reference, the zero height. That is all. Inside an electric circuit, inside an electronic circuit, well, we have a gravitational field there, but its effect is almost negligible. What really counts inside the electronic circuit is the presence of an electric field, a force field that pulls downwards along with it positive charges present in the cables, present in electric components inside the entire electronic circuit. So the purpose of a battery in an electronic circuit is the creation of an electric field inside the wires, along those wires, along all resistors, capacitors, inductors in the circuit. And that electric field is the one that will pull downwards all charges already present in those wires, in those resistors and those inductors. Without the electric field, there is no up or down for those charges, and those charges are sort of floating in mid-space inside the wires, pretty much like Sandra Bullock in the movie in Gravity. Without a field, a force field, there is no up or down. As a matter of fact, words like up or down, above, below, higher, lower, all of those, they have meaning to you and to me because we were born and we have always lived inside a gravitational field. Without a force field around us, up and down, we have no meaning. Well, guess what? When your battery creates a force field, an electric field that goes all the way along the wires in your electronic circuit, that field defines up and down, higher, lower, above and below for electric charges. But those differences in electric heights are not measured the way we measure differences in heights in our gravitational field, no. Not in joules per kilogram, no. We measure those differences in electric height inside the circuit in joules per coulomb. We say inside the wire, this point here is 3 joules per coulomb higher than this one. Joules per coulomb. We have seen that unit, right? Absolutely. That is the volt. When we say a point in the circuit is 3 volts higher than another one, what we mean is that this one is 3 joules per coulomb higher than this one. You say, well, what does it mean? What it means is that one positive coulomb up here has 3 joules more potential energy than the same coulomb down here. So to move that positive coulomb from the lower point to the higher point, we need to spend 3 joules of energy. Or if the coulomb, the positive coulomb is up here and we let it roll downhill along the electric field down to this point, that coulomb will release 3 joules of energy. You see? Thinking of volts as electric heights is not a metaphor. It is the truth. It is a reality. I hope I made you think a little bit about that. And in the meantime, think of something else. Gravitational heights are not absolute. The height or altitude of a city is always given with respect to a reference. We think of the altitude of Vancouver, New York City, Nepal, Lhasa, Peking, with respect to the sea level. That is a chosen level of reference, and that is sort of conventional. It is. But when we are flying an airplane, the zero level for heights is not the sea level. It is what? It is the runway of the airport where we're going to land our airplane. That is the zero level. So my point here is that heights are relative. And before we say this point is so many meters high, we have to say with respect to what? We choose a reference level. Inside an electronic circuit, it is the same thing. Before we give an electric height inside a circuit in volts, we say this point is 3 volts high. High with respect to what reference? Your chosen reference. So the first thing I'm going to ask you in the laboratory is to choose in a circuit a level of reference which is arbitrary. Arbitrary. And some of you are thinking, ground? No, not ground. Don't think of that. Ground would be a fine choice if your circuit is actually connected to the planet. That is fine. I normally choose that as my reference level, as my zero electric height level. But these days we have iPhones, we have portable computers, all sorts of things. And they are not connected to the planet, and in those circuits, thinking of ground is really doesn't make sense, right? So we choose any point in the circuit as our zero volts level. That is arbitrary, and then we measure with a voltmeter how much higher than that chosen reference every point in the circuit is, and that is something we will be doing in the laboratory. And that is all for now. Thank you very much, and I hope to see you in the next video.